trouble is if I paint the picture too well, you might fall in love with it. Oh, she was about 5'6", a little bag of...
And we're back.
Hey, welcome everybody. Thanks for tuning in to Air It Out. Free Hand Prophet. Across the table from me is Dano Holcomb, aka Late Night Color. And yeah, you know the drill. We're about to smoke and talk sneakers.
That's right. Another Wednesday sesh. What are we talking about today? I already see some Dior's, the lows up here. I don't want to get right into it.
I mean, fuck it. I mean, let's get right into it, man. Fucking, we ended off 2019 with photos of the Dior One Highs retailing at over $3,000. It's out of my price range.
Yeah, it's absolutely really, yeah.
I mean, Dior in general is out of my price range. So, like, that's kind of out there already.
It doesn't feel good to be left out of the pack completely. That's what kind of sours it a little bit.
I get you there. I'm a little bit like, people are starting to like the Jordan 1 lows all of a sudden.
Yeah.
I'm like, this ain't new. They've been around, and to me, they're still as trash as they ever been. No offense, KD, who said the Jordan 1 lows were some of the best Jordans.
Who said that?
Kevin Durant. Said yeah. That?
No way.
Said the Jordan 1 low is his favorite Jordan.
I'd love to know more about that. Like, if he's got a specific story about a pair or something.
Sure,
that's significant.
I'd love to hear the story, but I would definitely argue with it. At the end of the day, I still can't.
I remember getting a pair like of the like bread lows, like back in the thousands, and like feeling like I got the clown shoe version.
Exactly.
Of the shoe.
Exactly, and that's why it surprises me that someone like KD would feel so inclined towards the Jordan 1 low, because it strikes me as a shoe that would be better on not lanky, tall, skinny folks. Like, this is a shoe that's going to make you look taller and lankier.
Can you imagine him in a pair of Chuck All-Stars?
Oh my gosh.
It looks like Snoop Dogg, I'm thinking, right?
That's a big L. Like,
yeah,
uppercase
big time.
L.
Do a little on the connection.
Oh, I got you.
Okay, now this with the socks, though.
With the socks, it's
a
different
guy,
story.
Yeah, this guy's killing it right now.
I hope
but what are those
Dan
socks? What are those
paycheck?
Socks are running, you know what I mean?
Oh, guaranteed the socks are probably $750.
Yeah, they look great with the socks.
Agreed. But
so let's just finish our thoughts on this. Like, they look amazing. It's a nice grade. The materials look great. I like the
Do we know the retail
the
price
painted.
On the lows?
No, they can't be anything better than the highs. Why would they? Oh, like, we'll cut it in half for you guys.
That doesn't
totally
work
with
a luxury brand.
Yeah. I would love a pair to, like, be able to dress up and stuff. But it's just never going to happen at these price points.
I really could give a fuck less about these. Now, in having them in hand, maybe I'd feel a different way. Maybe that leather is a type of nice
connection again.
Again,
yeah. Might want to fuck with the HDMI cord itself.
Better.
Yeah. All right. What else we got?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. If you went out and spent like fucking over $10,000 on a pair of We the Best Musics,
We the
I'm
Best,
sure
the
you're
DJ
feeling
Khaled
pretty bad
threes,
right now.
You hot right now because these red cements are coming out for All-Star Weekend in February. It's a good fit for the fact that the All-Star game is back in Chicago, and so we see that Chicago Bulls colorway.
Yeah, this is a I'm going to need these kind of a thing. I hate to say it, but like I mean, love the Toro 4s. Like you'd put that, you and I did the same thing. It'd be sweet if they were red Nubuck, though.
I don't want the red Nubuck. Fuck the Nubuck.
Just in terms of the way that it would
fuck Nubuck in general.
Okay.
But if it was red suede,
okay,
you could have me on board with that. Like some Raging Bull 3s, I could fuck with that big time. But I was actually thinking a different direction. You were thinking that red could be a different material. I'm leaning towards, okay, this is a red iteration of the black cement 3s. But what if it was a red iteration of the white cements? What if that was tumbled leather on the tongue? Would that be as nice of a sneaker? Like, I can picture a lot of shit, but I honestly can't in my head picture whether a red cement is better in the white cement color blocking and materials or the black cement. They're very
close.
Isn't
it a red cement?
Yeah.
Like a red in the elephant?
No. I'm just calling these red cements because it's very clearly the sure. black cement color blocking.
Yes. And your question again is?
Would they look better in the white cement color blocking? If that tongue was red tumbled leather and it wasn't the gray, if it was...
Or wouldn't it be white? It wouldn't be white on the tongue?
Well, if you... Depends on how you did it, but here they just replace the red with the black.
The black with the red.
But yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So if you applied that to a white cement, I would imagine that the tongue would be red still.
Not necessarily. Because it matched white. Because it was white. Yeah.
Right. I mean, and we're talking hypothetically. So really, this is what needed to be done, and now we see it.
I love the gray tongue. I love the gray and the with the red embroidery.
From here, the gray tongue doesn't do it for me. From here, with the black laces going across it,
yeah.
I feel a different way. This is a Chicago Bulls shoe. This should have... I don't know how the fuck... It's 2020 and this is the first time this is happening.
It seems crazy.
Like the obvious thing to do.
Oh, yeah. Maybe that's why some people aren't liking it. It's just like they mailed it in or something. It's like, no, man. These are a solid pair that I want to have... My collection. Like today, I pulled out the True Blues today to wear to a game later, and these are what, 3 years old?
Yeah.
I didn't wear it for 3 years. Like, I'll have these and just keep them around for the right thing because these are solid as fuck. Got Nike Air on the back.
They do, don't they?
Yeah.
Yes, they do.
Like, that's a good view from back there.
I hope they do sleep. I'm wearing the Animal 3s right now, and I don't know how people slept on those.
Yeah, what has happened where the 3 is a slept-on shoe?
I'm not real disturbing, mad, except for, you know, when your favorites aren't getting the shine that they deserve, you're like, oh, shit, go ahead. I can pick these up on fucking sale racks. I can get these at the outlet, whatever. But then you're like...
You're just curious what the trends are saying. Like, why?
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah.
What else are you buying right now instead of this?
Right.
Let's see it.
Let's see. Well, what else are they buying? Oh, here's the top view.
Yeah, they're solid, man.
Very nice.
And we've seen other threes, like those chrome black ones. Not chrome, but like those three, the 3M tongue.
The Tinker joints.
With a little gold. Yeah.
Yeah, the Tinker joints.
I guess those would apply to the Art Takers.
Right. These shits look great, though. Red cements. I'm going to have to go after a couple of pairs simply for the fact that they got to get chopped.
Yeah, these make great masks, right?
Great masks.
Yeah.
And like, the white cement and the black cement masks are some of my favorites. These red cements are going to be no exception.
Okay.
These, though... Top 3 Jordan 5s, combination of the metallic 5s, the fire red 5s, and the grapes.
Yeah.
Into one atrocious ass beast.
Yep, not into that. Plus, what are we talking about on the tongue? It's all Nubuck, right? you were just extremely adverse to the Nubuck.
I do not like Nubuck.
I like Nubuck on fours, and I'd like a three. Do you've seen those threes? That are I think Mayer has them. They're like black Nubuck. I think Clark Kane has a pair.
It's so rare that we see quality Nubuck, and that's why I say fuck Nubuck, because it's one in like 30 pairs with Nubuck is actually worth a damn.
What about like the fours?
I have not seen Nubuck on fours that I gave a fuck about in a long time.
Like, Buzz is rocking the hell out of his, and they don't look terrible.
The royalty fours, the black with the gold, you got a pair in your office right now. That's suede.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like that.
Dude, those have worn nicely, and I have a tree of those nicely.
The bread fours aren't shit because of that Nubuck. The last time I saw a Nubuck that impressed me was the 2010, I want to say, infrared pack. The black infrared sixes that I chopped down for that mask. That shit was buttery, velvety, smooth. That shit was nice.
Which pair?
The black infrared sixes from the infrared pack that came in the like Mylar foil bags. I want to say it was 2010, but it was the black infrareds and the white infrareds. And the black infrareds from that pack has the nicest Nubuck that I've seen on any release.
That's one of the reasons I haven't worn my infrared sixes yet.
Because the Nubuck is disappointing?
Yeah.
And you got the pair with the Nike Air on the back.
Yeah.
The most recent release. Yeah. I have the release from before that that still has the Jumpman on the back. They're looking all right, but, like, Nubuck doesn't hold up. It gets all those, like scuffs that are, like, just compressed, like, hairs or whatever. And it just looks... You can't do nothing with that shit.
Yeah, I'm afraid to wear them. Even with these... I got these for them. Like, got these... What are these? I forget the brand name because they don't do a good job of that here. There's a little logo over here, but...
Huh.
Got some sort of shield on it. Guys, do better branding so then I can share your shit.
Four shields, soul shields.
Yeah.
What shield is souls.
Is that what I say?
No.
Yeah, doesn't say anything. Anyways. Second.
Now you got these crease protectors for which pair?
I got them for a couple pairs. You put them in there, they're flexible. These shit's been like this around for a long time, but I've not gotten these. I've only gotten like the old like ones that were like foam. They were like way more full here.
I've had foam. I've had the ones that are even stiffer plastic than that are more rigid.
These are pretty flexible.
It really depends on the shoe and the fit for me, whether I can even stand wearing them. This looks pretty good. I like this grip that it has so that it looks like it's not going to slide up and down the toe box.
Yeah, it definitely didn't seem too slippery in there. I put a pair in a pair of Don C 312s today because I actually like those.
Yep.
But the one pair that I bought like day one had this crease in it that made it look like you had it for a year and a half and you wore them every single day.
Yeah.
And I'm like, bro, this is day one. So I bought these and it definitely helped fill
it
out.
It is the Jordan 1 toe box. I mean,
Jordan 1 toe box going into. With way more room to move because it's on a three midsole.
You know, the crease
and then it's like a strap. A low strap is down there, pinching everything together. Yeah, there's a lot going on that can cause an issue.
I've been tempted to buy some of the 312s just to kind of like have in the collection, like the all black elephant print with the infrared. Just because I got, you know.
Dude, I like them. They're comfortable. You get that big Jordan 1 tongue.
They're comfortable. You just said they got this big, nasty, creasy toe box. It was comfortable, built though.
If you wanted to just, like, have a pair to beat.
To beat around. Yeah. I get that.
And they change per color. Like, this one had this white leather toe box that was very soft.
Okay.
I have a black pair that's not nearly as soft.
That's not that soft. See, but I like the soft leather.
I do, too. It gives it that more luxe feel.
Yeah. Yeah.
They just needed some help. And
they need a little help. The crease protectors, that'll do the trick. So you know, we were not impressed with the denim sixes. I don't think anybody really was. But this is what I was waiting for, was to see the customizers do their thing. And this is a fairly simple bleach job.
Okay. I was going to ask, like, not acid wash.
No.
Just bleach. Bleach and some, probably some Dremel.
Yeah, maybe some sanding. Yep. This is what we expected to see, and it looks a lot better than what was actually released. That is for sure.
Yeah. It's just totally lost on me.
Yeah. I saw somebody else dye them and bleach them olive, so they looked like a poor man's Travis Scott.
Yeah. I can see that. They put the laces in them.
Yeah, I'm sure. But, like, the amount of time that went into turning them into that, I was like, just pay the resale price. The DMP6s are rumored to be dropping March.
I think, yeah, they moved them back. I think it was supposed to drop earlier.
Yeah, there's rumors of All-Star. It's just a classic pair that, like, I think any sneakerhead that came about in the era that I did, like, has a respect for this shoe. I mean, if you're a fan of classic Jordans, this is that classic Jordan color blocking with just little pops of gold.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the gold on the midsole doesn't impress me much, but man, that kind of chrome gold on the heel tab,
yeah,
definitely
sure
catches my eye a little bit more. I wish the lace toggle was a chrome gold as well. I think they missed on doing that, but other than that, it's nice.
But you're not gonna get these. You're not getting Jordans
right now. Of
course not. I don't
give a fuck about Nubuck.
Yeah, Nubucks or Jordans right now.
I got my infrared sixes. Like, I don't really need much else. You know, definitely not another pair of all black Nubuck. These are limited to just 5,000 pairs, man. Chinese New Year Jordan 1 Low.
Yeah, when you look at the details on this, it kind of gets interesting.
I have to agree with that.
That's, and here is Wade, this is, I want to bring attention up that, because we were just saying we don't like
Jordan 1 Lows.
Jordan 1 Lows, but like, sure, this is a crazy Jordan 1 Low.
It's not like, oh, this is a fantastic shoe. It's a beautiful shoe because of the materials and how they applied the embroidery and all the considerations for storytelling and all that.
And the two different colored outsoles.
Love to, yeah.
There's a lot of,
exactly,
like,
I would love to see this whole colorway applied to a different shoe, and then I'd be like, yo, I need to get that shit. Now I'm just like, yo, that's nice. If you like Jordan 1 Lows, that's the pair to fucking get right there.
Them, especially limited to 5,000.
Yeah.
Gonna have that rarity. And this is another Chinese here.
That is correct.
Jordan 34, which I am loving the death out of right now. I wear both my pairs a lot. They're just comfortable.
I've seen three or four other people get and wear their 34s because of you, Dano.
Okay, I'll take that. I will probably get at least one more pair before it's all said and done. Just waiting for that one color that I can't deny. The orange ones, I honestly want. The ones that Melo's been playing in a lot.
Like, you think you'll catch those at the outlet or something?
I'm hoping. I didn't even think about that. I need to chill out with that, yeah, and see what hits the outlets. We need to take another one of those runs down the way here. It's not that far.
I have to agree with that. We got to do the bigger field trip, too. Some of the other spots are a little bit of a drive out there.
Let's do it.
You also need to take another trip up to Portland, see our boy David. Here's another pair of 34s for you, Dano. You sure this isn't the one?
Yeah, I'm very sure.
These iridescents are fire.
I love the ass on these things, but, like, no, I don't like the strip. I wish that the iridescent was reserved simply for that. Like, I wish it wasn't on this whole strip.
Okay.
Going up the side of the shoe. I think that could have been.
I kind of wish it was on the.
Yeah, that would have made that kicking, dude.
What's that? What are we calling
it? I think they're calling it an eclipse plate.
an eclipse plate.
Yeah.
Right there in the arch going into the heel.
Which they've done like fun stuff like the blue pair that I have or the blue void pair I have has like an iridescent situation going on. But yeah, like you said, missed opportunity here with that. Even though these are amazing. Like I love, again, the ass in these is nuts.
And
I think you can't even see the E on this one on the right until
because
you get
it's
the right
yellow.
Light.
Yeah, the letter in Nike matches the ribbon of color on the heel tab.
Didn't notice that. Yeah, but the rear end of these in general is a good look. Like it's one of the main reasons I like the shoe.
What a sweet caboose on these.
Mm-hmm.
More 34s, Dano.
Okay, now these, the
Paris
ones.
Joints.
Although, we've mentioned how that that eclipse plate is a little inappropriate.
That eclipse plate, a.k.a. moon cup. that shit, that's so nice.
Actually, they can't
that
even
shit
see
looks like look like the inside of a clamshell.
But I love the upper and the weird, you know, like drips of color and where it's very imperfect.
Yeah.
I like the laces, the lace system on these. I like the laces. I like everything about this shoe. It's just a solid.
This solid is a beautiful, beautiful shoe. I'm hoping we have more pictures of it. Yes, we do.
And this is showing a lot of the tech in there where this, the purple or whatever you want to say, just stops.
Right there.
That's the gusseted part of the tongue that would like come up if you were to pull up the tongue. But it's just mesh back there.
All this would make way more sense to me if I could get a pair to chop up. I guess I should look into that. We gotta start doing chops on the show, man. That way we can talk about all the tech inside. I got some 33s to cut up.
Yes, you do. Some big ass ones, right?
Oh, look at that pink Band-Aid. I do. I think
I know.
Size
and I remember
15.
When we originally talked about this shoe, you were laughing like, even with this Band-Aid, your shoe got a boo-boo.
Your shoe got a boo-boo. It does. Your shoe got a boo-boo.
But you just move on.
It grows on you.
Yeah. It's almost like a second skin.
Oh, God. This motherfucker. Well, somebody call for a brief. Because you got some excess skin removed here. I guess you could say it's a 34 skin.
Oh my god. Alright. I'm going to take the joint.
There you go. Oh, wait.
Yeah.
Did I say 5,000? I meant.
No, you said 5,000 on
for
the drawer
Chinese.
The most.
Yeah, there you go. There's only 500 of these. So, it's a stretch. Especially considering Nike has put the nix on European and Asian retailers shipping their product to the U.S.
Yeah, these will only be released in Paris, yeah?
I'm fucking so salty about that shit. Like, that and, you know, the possible World War III is probably, like, the worst way you could start out 2020. Still a very promising year. There's a lot of good to look forward to. But there's some bullshit, man, that is unnecessary. You fucking with my collection, and you fucking with these retailers' pockets.
And this was Nike's decision.
This was Nike's decision.
Yeah, this was.
I have a feeling though, it has more to do with
sanctions and shit.
Customs and tariffs, and
if anyone there is following the political situation closer than we are, you could fill us in. If it was,
if you really know your shit, you can come on the show and fill everybody in.
Mm-hmm.
We are looking at guests for the new season and the new year. So if you have any requests or suggestions or you think you need to be on this motherfucker to talk to us, smoke with us, and talk about kicks, reach out. Let us know.
Yeah, we're going to be reaching out for the next couple weeks trying to schedule the rest of the season. Already excited that we have a couple people booked. And filling it out is going to be fun for sure.
These bespoke Air Max 1s that I spotted over on Nice Kicks.
This is from Nice
are
Kicks?
Are insane. Yeah. Hold on.
The bokeh on the photo. Whatever.
I had some notes that I left over here with the customizer's name on there. We'll have to put it in the episode description so you guys can see the artist work.
Yeah, these are gorgeous. Mini swoosh and all.
Yeah, and the python just on the toe box.
Yeah, and the pony hair.
Mesh on the tongue.
The use of the pony hair.
Oh, yep. Yeah, I didn't even see the pony hair at first. Mini swoosh. Very nice. Kerwin Frost has got an Adidas collab coming up.
I haven't seen this photo.
I wanted to save this one for you. I thought you'd get a kick out of this. Apparently, my man's is a Adidas head for real, for real. He got three stripes on his mind. Yeah, we don't really know what to expect.
It's a weird hybrid cone head.
Like. Yeah, very, very much like a cone head. Very cool. It looks like some real life special effects application, like makeup effects. I could be wrong, but that looks like they actually made that happen. Here's some of the other fun that he's having over at Adidas. Doesn't tell us shit about what's coming. But this one made me laugh.
This is
amazing.
The
fucking three stripes on the Yeti. Fucking priceless.
So yeah, I've just seen some videos of him hosting and interviewing. Yeah. I haven't seen much else. I don't really know. I know he dresses all wild.
So he's not actually a Yeti or a Martian or a
Conan? I think he could be all of the above. I don't know. But I'm excited to see whatever he comes out with. Unless it's not as funny as these fucking photos. If the shoes aren't like insane pushing the boundary stuff, then I don't understand what this collaboration's all about.
This one just weirds me out a little bit.
Yeah, this makes you uncomfortable.
Okay, you sent me these.
These Stormtrooper joints.
Yeah, these are the Prada.
I don't know what they're called.
God, for some reason I want to call them the Clout Chasers. That's not what they are. It's like Cloud Chaser or some shit. Real
I
talk.
Hope it's not called the Cloud Chaser.
It's some shit. Like,
all right. Well, let's hope it's not that. You have any of the other colors?
Yeah, we got. Yeah. Look at the green right here.
Well, it's funny because Frankie reacted to these. He was like, the night before, he asked what the Tesla Cybertruck would look like as a shoe.
Yeah, I sent him the Kobe Adidas,
and he showed me that, and I was like, that's a good call. And then I further explained to him that was a real shoe.
Yeah,
and it was worn on court. But these deliver some of that vibe, I think.
You think so?
Yeah.
These got Tron vibes to me.
For sure. The glowing and the piping.
Yeah.
Love the armor layering, how it goes over the top.
I have to agree.
And the squared toe is definitely a strong feature.
Yeah, I'd rock these in this green. This is actually like a pale blue, it looks like.
Yeah, like an ice, like a glacier blue.
It's almost too pale. I'm like, is that white? That's some Stormtrooper shit for sure.
That's awesome. I'm going to say, yeah, whoever designed these, I like these.
Definitely better than the incarnation of these previous.
Which is what?
Again, it's the name of the model. Fuck me for not remembering. We were just talking about this shit yesterday.
The Cloud Chasers?
The Cloud Chasers. The Prada Cloud Chasers. Yo.
These should have been after the Kerwin Frost.
I have to agree. These Cookie Monster Converse joints.
Cookie Monster.
These are Ambush collab. That are reportedly coming out. Now, this isn't something that I would necessarily want to wear, but I like fucking looking at them.
Oh, yeah. Reminds me a little bit of Monsters, Inc.
Yeah, definitely Cookie Monster.
They look inviting. Yeah. Like, there's going to be some cute girls, I would say, rocking this in really fun ways. Like with wild outfits. Like Charmaine was here earlier with a big furry jacket on. I could even see her wearing these and it not being that weird.
I can see that. I can see that. I wonder what they look like shaved. this, if nothing else, if I don't get any other W's for the year, if I don't buy another sneaker for the rest of the year, let it be the Bacon Air Max 90.
All right. I had no idea you were this excited. You've kept that reserved.
I had no fucking hope of these
would ever come back out. Yeah, this is totally one of those blindsided. Big surprises for sure.
We haven't seen them retro a quality Air Max for Air Max Day since the Atmos Jade, and that was
a pack with Jordan
2015.
Yeah, 2016, 2015.
Okay.
Yeah,
it's been a few years now. Like, I really hoped that that was going to be something that was recurring. You have deep archives and plenty of pairs.
Yeah, but I've always been conflicted with that. Like, do you want them to keep bringing back, like, these iconic
shoes? I don't want to see these shoes just disappear. No, because at a certain point, they're going to, like, just disappear anyway. Like, I don't want to see them every 4 years. I don't want to see them every six. I want to see them every 10, 15 years.
No, I get it. Like, as long as it would take to truly take care and wear out a pair.
Exactly. If you take care of your shit, a pair that you really love and take care of and cherish can last you good 8 to 12 years.
And how are you going to deny the excitement that you're having right now? Like, I would do anything. If that's the only pair you want for the rest of the year, that says a lot, dude.
That's what I'm saying. If there's one win for this year, I have to leave 2020 with my Bacons.
Get that bacon.
Get that bacon. Bring the bacon home. Fry it up in the pan. We got the rumors, and I'm pretty sure we're confirmed for the red off-white 90s dropping in All-Star Weekend. We saw these the Look-See sample at MCA. I'll be interested to see what actually drops. Some folks are putting Photoshops out like this, which it's cool. I could see them going that way.
This is way more interesting than the all red for sure.
I want to see the actual shoe. We'll see. Yeah. I would rather it not be the icy sole. I would rather it be a solid midsole.
I won't be losing any sleep.
I still want the Desert Ores. I need to just pull the trigger and order them shits. That might be a treat for this year. These Tom and Jerry's though. Okay, so this is a pack of four, and it's three Club C's, but one Instapump Fury, and the Instapump Fury has my full undivided attention. The fucking storytelling is on point, from the scratches on the midsole to the exclamations on the back heel, the branding on the pull tabs, the pink on the back of the tongue, the gray fur. This is really, really a dope sneaker.
Yeah, this is on point. My dad's name is Tom. His brother's name is Jerry.
Oh,
so
shit.
I've grown up with a lot of
hijinks?
Tom and Jerry shit in the house, and grew up loving watching Tom and Jerry. Dude, it's crazy watching it now how incredibly violent it is. You know what I mean? Like, dude, just getting his ass handed to him in every which way the entire time. And they complain about, like, violence in video games and shit like that these days. It's
nowadays,
like, dude, whatever.
You know, it's all foolishness. I didn't become a violent person because I watched Tom and Jerry.
Yeah, love what they did here on the Club C.
Yeah, this one is probably not my favorite of the pack out of the four. Maybe my least favorite of the pack.
Yeah, these brown ones.
I like these Club C's probably the best.
I like Harry Suede in a lot of ways.
I like this too. This is just nice use of it. A nice, loose suede.
And like these are actually like a wearable pair regardless of them being Tom and Jerry.
Yep.
I don't think. You know
Absolutely.
What I mean? Like, I can see people wearing these and loving them without there being the affiliation. Although that kid's pair, dude, is where it's at.
I really like the stamp on the tongue.
Yeah, dude.
The tongue stamp on the tongue. The baby Instapump Fury is pretty great.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna need the pair of baby shoes.
You're gonna go for the baby pair. Yeah. I'm going for the full size. I yeah, those are crazy, dude.
I like how the toe or the right looks like a like the nose.
Yes, I was thinking the same thing. That black leather.
And then it looks like there's a tail in the back.
Yeah. Is this cash? Is there a little bit more in there?
Definitely a little bit more.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, these are awesome.
Shout out to Hoob's Glass.
Yeah,
that's
dude.
What we're smoking out of.
Constantly.
Soak in some more of these details. Talking about the 30th anniversary of the Air Max 90. It's also the 30th anniversary of the Adidas ZX 8000.
And I'm not an Adidas guy. It's pretty clear. You know what I mean? Like, I don't wear a bunch of Adidas classics. But when it does... What these do interest me big time. Like, all the old ZX trainers, like, they hit me similar to the way the old Air Maxes do. Where it's that trainer shape. It's an old runner. And it's a lot of fun materials being used. I love that. The lines on the mesh.
You like that?
Yeah.
I can dig that. I like Koji's over at Atmos. He got the snakeskin on them joints.
Can we go back one?
Yeah.
Yeah, why does the yellow on his toe pop so much more?
The variation in color in these is vast. Now, this was the inspiration behind the ZX Lion or ZX Pride that I did for Adidas London.
Oh, yeah.
That's hanging in their shop on Oxford Street. And there are, you know, just like we've seen the variations in... The infrared color from the infrared 6s to the infrared 90s, depending on what year and the release. These colors vary quite a bit, and sometimes you'll see them without the mesh in the back and the heel cup. Sometimes you'll see them a little bit more muted, lighter, or a little bit more vibrant. It looks like Koji's Atmos release was a little bit more vibrant. I think the purple might be a patent leather or maybe a little bit more of a smoother leather as opposed to this.
It's definitely
the darker
purple
suede,
at least in
here.
This lighting, for sure.
It's also the 30th anniversary of the Gel Light 3. We got the Sean Witherspoons dropping. See, I'm not a corduroy guy.
It's hard to keep him clean. I like the way he uses it. He really plays with the way they position the lines. And
as much as
fun.
I'm one for Velcro, I'm not sure that this is...
I feel like this is too big of a piece.
He reached,
to apply.
Reached a little too far.
Yeah, it's like the whole... Like on a varsity jacket, like if you were to Velcro the whole letter.
The big letter? The big varsity letter?
Like it's not going to look right.
We'll see.
But do you have the picture of like them with the yellow on? Like that? See, that's just solid. Like I would like this pair of Jet Light 3s, and I don't really go for a lot of those. Just because it is this fun arrangement of corduroy colors.
Right.
So therefore, that aesthetic works, dude. Like the way he's using corduroy colors and stuff.
I think so. Well, and I think it's a style too that he's helped pioneer with the vintage and all of that.
I just like his color palette, like the way he uses colors, like he puts
I do
it
too.
Together.
I think if I saw his same color palette without the corduroy, I would be much more inclined to it. If this was all loose suede, I'd be like, oh yeah, need those. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And that's just personal taste. I'm digging these OGs, which is more of a infrared colorway. They're bringing this retro colorway back. Keep an eye out for these. Not really sold on the mesh on the OGs here. I know that's a classic thing, but I kind of want to see it like fill out the window.
These are fucking sick.
These are a collab with Mida. There's a lot of details to soak in here. First of all, the woven lining, but then the quilted sock liner around that.
Yeah, zoom in on that liner, the details in there. Yeah, I just can't get enough of stuff like that. The piping around the toe.
Oh, the toe box, yeah.
No. These are looking really good. Yeah.
Ties in the Japanese flag with the red toe box and the white body.
Oh, well, there you see this, and you see that like that. You see the circular shape that it gives off. Oh, man, that's dope.
Absolutely.
So if they were like toe to toe,
yeah, it would definitely look like the Japanese flag.
Very cool. Oh, humble brag.
Some Nike by You, aka Nike IDs, yesterday.
I got to get a pair.
Yeah, man. The recrafted 90s, they just dropped with, you know, it's not any crazy materials. It's not any super crazy colors, but it's a fresh palette. And I am.
It's the cut.
It's part of my collection is to just kind of, whenever they drop a new option of custom 90s, I'm going to get a pair. At least.
Yeah, I got to get a pair of these too. I hope they don't sell out really quickly.
I would be surprised. I think these are going to be the options for a while. People wait for
that.
They're
solid. They're solid.
Levi's or Pendleton.
Whatever. Drop. You can have it. Yeah, these look great. Well done.
It's interesting too because like.
Do they offer an extra lace option?
What?
Do they? I asked.
Oh, do they? Yeah. Not that I know of, no.
Remember when they used to offer that? You could be like for extra $4 or something.
Yeah, exactly.
Because that changed up the whole thing where it's like, oh, I can do this with this. Uh-huh. I mean, I would have got the
olives as well now. Because like I got plenty of gym red laces, but I don't know that I have that particular olive.
I almost
want to
see that midsole color on the lace.
Oh, the sale? Maybe.
I don't know. I just that's what
I got.
I
sale laces.
See it.
I got a few pairs of sale laces.
Shit, I got sale laces.
Shit.
Yeah, these are solid, man.
Appreciate it. Well, you guys will see them when they.
Yeah, if you know Gary, he's all about
the olive infrared,
the pimento stuffed olive, exactly what we got here.
Maybe I'll bring the whole generation.
Could you change the lining color on the tongue?
No.
That had to match the mesh color on the top.
Yes, exactly. Okay. That was not an option. It is.
I like that it's kind of that smooth nylon shit on the tongue.
Yeah. I think because you couldn't even choose the materials. A lot of times you have an option of like mesh here, leather here, all of that. But it's all classic blocking. Just like the infrareds, it's suede overlay. Leather, mud guard, mesh toe box, nylon tongue. That's how it is.
Yep.
So, it's pretty cool. But you can choose your heel tab both colors.
You were saying that you can choose the logo color and the tab color, right?
Agreed.
Which is nice.
Yeah. It's been a while since you could do that. In other news, we got the Tailgate 350s coming. A little reminiscent of the Beluga colorway. I dig this. I might keep an eye out for these.
I will agree that this is like a really solid color of this shoe that I can see selling a lot of pairs.
You're like, whatever. Next. Yeah, we got a joint. Don't worry. We got to spark the joint when we get to the verses. We still got pickups and shit,
oh,
bro.
Oh, shit. Wait, so we get load a bowl? Can we load a bowl?
Yeah, load a bowl, man. I don't want to stop you from smoking. The Earth colorway doesn't look like much here. I'm sure it just... I mean, the midsole looks like slug guts. But I'm a little bit intrigued why the toe looks like it's like a light gum. And the heel looks like it's like this radioactive volt color. So
that's a two-piece construction on this one.
It is,
right?
But that
it wraps around the. I want to. What?
It's the bottom. So this side panel is one piece.
Yeah.
And then from that heel, from that yellow green heel, and the whole bottom of the sole up to that little toe cap is one piece.
So it has a bright outsole,
that should be
maybe?
One color. And I can't tell if it's more of a honey or if it's like this bright green.
Let's find more photos. Maybe on the next
one. Maybe next time. I want to see this shit in person. Yeah, there you go. We need to call Grassdoor, bro.
No shit.
The speaking of classics coming back, the Plum SBs are making a return.
What fun color. I'm a sucker for purple and red.
I think it's good. I think it's good. I'm sure there'll be some salty OGs, but refer back to my bacon commentary. These shit's got to come back so that the Young Bucks can enjoy the classics as well. And this is a beauty. These materials look great.
Yeah, dude, that tongue. They do, and I know from experience that like the suede toe buns are just so comfortable. They're just loose and. Remember, I wore the shit out of my Venoms. Those are the ones that I wore like the most. This is black and white. I put some teal laces in them.
Shout out to Nike for doing the hard work for me. These are available February 7th for $110 on Nike sneakers. They put it right there in the ad. Appreciate that. Appreciate that. I appreciate the transparency in your advertising. We watched the Martin Lawrence, Will Smith sneaker shopping with Joe LaPuma on Complex. And it was just really good to see such legends of the sneaker world just doing their thing.
Yeah, no, this was a really good episode. I don't watch a lot of this show anymore unless it's like the host.
It's definitely
the
one of
the
best things on Complex.
This show?
Yeah, sneaker shopping. I mean, depending on the guest, of course, but Joe does a great job.
I can't think of another show to.
I mean, some of the prices that
I like Hot Ones. Is that on Complex technically?
I think it. What I mean, maybe I'm wrong. I don't know. Yeah, it is. Was.
Yeah.
Fuck me. That's another great example. I didn't say it was the best. I just said it is one of the best.
But this episode is one of the best episodes I've ever seen. These guys clearly had a fun time.
And heartfelt.
Yeah.
Humble.
And good stuff. Like, there was good, you know, you heard good stories from Fresh Prince. You heard him talk about the Friends and Family pair and PJ Tucker wearing them.
Yeah.
And he goes, he shouldn't do that.
Martin talking about LeBron doing the Martin, was it the 16s?
Yeah, dude, that's the best moment. Yeah. For sure.
Releasing on his birthday, like, you could really tell how much that meant to him, and I don't know. For both of these men brought so much joy into our lives and so much influence into the world that we now reside in. That it's just good to see, man. It's good to see these guys doing well, and I'm hyped to see Bad Boys for Life. I'm looking forward to that shit.
It looks pretty funny. And it's so cool that like sneakers are the thing that like were the conduit of that. You know what I mean? Like that he did that release on his birthday with such a dope shoe. You've seen him out in person, right? Like with the multicolored laces and shit.
Yeah.
Like they look dope. And there's many forms of like flattery and appreciation and stuff, but like to have LeBron James, one of the greatest basketball players of all time, released a shoe with that inspiration.
I was thinking about this shit the other day. He's on his 17th signature sneaker.
Yeah.
He's got at least 3 years in him.
Yeah.
We're going to see someone with 20 signature sneakers that were worn in consecutive seasons.
It's crazy. Mean, and he's already there. That's, I mean, that's old one's already being retroed.
Yeah.
Like while he's still playing.
Yeah, while he's still playing. That's fucking crazy.
He's like wearing his old stuff. Like it's.
Yeah.
And plus now the regulations are so different. And it's
how old are the rookies going into the NBA draft?
19 at the youngest, I think.
So in the next few years, LeBron is going to be playing against people that were born after he started playing in the league. He's going to be playing against people who were never alive when he did not play in the NBA.
That's crazy. Yeah.
That's fucking insane.
Yeah, that's true.
That's insane. All right.
He's already playing against really young people like Luka Doncic. Okay, we got versus.
Oh, wait. Are we doing the pickups first?
Let's do pickups first.
Let's do these undefeated 90s, man. All right. I got a couple of these ready to go. We got the white and solar red up right now. Folks slept on these, Dano. These were not hard to get. And I'm not really that upset about that. I don't often buy 8 pairs of sneakers in one day. But this was a treat yourself moment. I'm a little bit completionist when it comes to my sneaker collection. You know how I feel about Air Max 90s. And I honestly could not decide
these colors, dude.
Which pair I wanted. And the materials are fantastic. The leathers are quality. Heel tabs look great. Extra laces, details on the aglets, and the lace locks.
Yeah, man,
folks were complaining so that they were simple. But you know what? Sometimes simple is what you need, man. You know what?
Actually, you don't put any of them away. I want all of them out at one point.
This though, because you know, and I especially sneaker Twitter hates people who mismatch sneakers, but guess what? That's me. I do that shit. I don't give a fuck what you think. This shit looks dope as fuck to me, and for someone who has trouble making decisions in the morning, this is like, okay, yeah, I'll do that. And this whole pack. Wait, hold up. You gonna open it. Oh, wait.
Oh, dude, those lime ones.
I know. Hold on. Yo, look. Watermelon pack, bro. This is that shit. This is that shit, man.
Yo, what do those look like?
Well, we're only halfway through this, too. Like,
insane.
I mean, putting the green laces into the solar red pair.
I'm here for it.
Wait, White and yellow is probably the one pair that maybe I would have passed on.
No, bro.
But,
dude, those are amazing.
I have to agree.
Fucking glass of lemonade right there.
See? See?
Yeah, that's a nice ass yellow.
See? Okay, but also,
let's see the black and yellow.
Tell me the solar red and yellow aren't going to be a good combo. Even if you don't mismatch the shoes, but like swap the different laces in, that's a good match. These Wu-Tang joints. Fucking black and yellow. Man, I'm telling you, this leather is fantastic. Feel that mud guard right there.
Yeah, these look amazing. I still can't believe they're sitting around, technically.
They sold out on Sneakers app, but they were on the Undefeated site for a grip. And resell it right now is, I think, below retail. Ask me if I give a fuck. That just tells me I'm going to go ahead and wear these with no problem. Because if I really fall in love with them, like I often do after wearing a pair, I'll just double down later. And ain't no one gonna fight me for them. Daniel, I ain't got enough room for all these shoes on this table, bro.
They're clean, you can stack them.
There it is, player. My guilty move for 2019. Now I gotta work extra hard in 2020. Let's go. I don't even think I have enough room in the apartment for all these damn shoes, bro.
Alright, so this all of them right now?
This is all of them, man.
Yeah, these are gorgeous.
Have to agree.
I think if I ever was going to get one pair right now, it's going to be these.
Really? The white and green?
Yeah, those are fucking clean, dude.
All right. Let me get these off the table. And then we'll get the verse going.
Yeah, thanks for bringing all those in.
Oh, Lord. I've been sitting on them, too. Waiting to wear them soon.
Now you got it.
Soon. I got to do my Air Max math so that I finish out my collection in Air Max month. We'll see. You got that slide pulled up, Dano?
Yes,
sir. Round one is up. I'm about to spark this joint. We got a few verses, and then that's it for tonight's episode.
Let's see this.
We got Glowing Souls and Gray Suede up first. We got Cause versus Kanye. I think I know what you're going to say.
What's the actual verses here? What's the question?
What's the better shoe here? Yeah, what's better, man?
As simple as this.
It could be whatever criteria that you think.
I'm going to say the Yeezy on this.
What?
Yeah.
That is not at all what I thought was going to be said right there.
I'm glad I can at least get some shock value out of this.
Wait, for real?
out of these two shoes, after these two like actual releases, for me, yes.
Dano, I don't even know the man sitting across the table from me right now.
I'll surprise you sometimes.
Sometimes. It's a little zinger here.
I was not impressed with the cause. Not at all. I was, like, not into them. I don't, like, the black ones more. I like the black ones more.
I do. I am drawn to the black pair more.
In general, like, I was not like, oh, man.
The gray I need those.
I didn't feel that way.
I love that.
There's something about the Yeezys that I've always wanted a pair of those. Not necessarily that colorway. I want the OG, like, the, like, sale and the...
The sale. Same colorway, but with the sale.
Yeah. Super solid.
Damn. All right. Dano goes for the 750s. I'm partial to the
That's
fours.
What's really fun about doing verses. I love doing verses.
Yeah. Good. I got to go with the Jordan 4. I don't get me wrong. I love the 750s. This is a difficult decision for me, but I've made the companion mask out of the Jordan 4s, so I've
and
worked
amazing
with them.
Work. Amazing work.
Thank you, sir. And as much as I'm like really impressed by a gum sole that glows, and I bet you that glow is even stronger because there's more rubber there, so that means more glow material. That minty green on the Cause 4s reminds me of Daiquiri Ice, one of my favorite ice creams.
Okay.
And so
there's a strong connection there.
Yeah. Sixes!
six. Gatorade on this.
Gatorade, huh? Yeah.
No question for me. Gatorade all the way.
Yeah,
You're the other way or what?
This one's straight up just a tie for me. I just like them both. Like,
you like to wear them both together?
No, but I would like to see both of them. Like, okay, I don't have the desire necessarily to own these shoes, but
neither
they would look really nice in the boxes, in my clear drop front boxes, right below my infrared sixes. So it'd be like black, green, pink. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, there's some of that draws my attention to these. We got some Kyrie collab face-offs. We got the... I'm drawing a complete blank on the name for the most recent Concepts collab here.
Because there's so many right now, and
there's so many Kyrie things,
so many colors, so many names, and they're all like interesting names. Like,
yeah,
this starts with I don't know what that's called, but like this one is one of the cooler ones for sure.
I have to agree. So but I have a pair SpongeBob.
Now. Yeah, I really, honestly, here I would take the SpongeBob's. Already have two pairs of the SpongeBob set. I really like the Mr. Krabs.
I can dig that. Do you like the two lows?
Never had a pair.
Okay.
I've only seen them more recently with these really cool. I just saw the Tiger or Sunset pair that they did, like the Air Max Pluses. They're a solid shoe.
I feel like the Concepts gets my vote. They wouldn't get as much wear as the SpongeBob's might, as far as like wearability for my wardrobe. I feel like John could flex those SpongeBob's on a regular basis. But the swoosh, that abalone, that's what I think it looks like. And then that translucent strap and heel cup. Damn, girl. You're kind of cute.
Yeah, it's so dope.
And like, I feel like there's a Dragon Ball character I can make out of them motherfuckers. All right.
Okay.
Golden SB face off. Lucky Sevens versus the Luck Cat.
Lucky Cat, right? It's like seven for me, for sure.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Same, bro.
Yeah.
Same.
It's funny, we just saw PJ Tucker wearing these in his episode of Singer Shopping.
That is why.
And he styled it properly with that green hoodie. Yeah, it's. I love the anything Irish stuff. You know what I mean? Like, I'm all about that. I even like those Rodriguez dunks just because, like. Actually, I'm thinking Christmas shit.
So these fall into like part of because are you a Celtics fan?
No.
No. You're a Clippers fan.
Clippers fan, but I do have a Boston Celtics jersey that I got
that's
just for my
thinking.
33rd birthday.
That's what it was. Okay.
It was for my 33rd birthday.
So I just have
plus
this, like,
I do like I'm I do like my Irish heritage and like I like wearing green.
Okay.
So this works for me.
Okay. Fair enough. I think the contrast stitching on the Luck Cats kind of throws me off. And I really like the depth of... Is that Nubuck? Is that Nubuck that I like on those Lucky Sevens?
No, I think it's Nice Suede.
Nice Suede. There you go. Suede's better than Nubuck. You heard it here first. Probably not here first. Thank you very much. How about some 700 V3s? With the glow cage versus the 380s.
No question.
No question for you, huh?
V3s.
I want them both, bro.
Yeah, I really do want to put those on and see what those feel like. I like the lines all over them. They're wild. I know there's going to be something that I don't like about them, which is how sharp those lines are going down the upper around the laces. And how that'll like end up not being perfect. We'll see. I don't know.
We'll see.
I'm curious.
We'll see. I am curious as well. I'm curious about the 380s, but I would tip the scales to the 700 V3 for consistent wearability. I feel like I would enjoy wearing the 380s, but the 700s I would wear more often.
The 380?
I would wear the 700s more
often.
No,
but...
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
That's what that's called? 380, right?
Yeah.
That one looks very comfortable. And I'm not a big fan of that sock stuff, but the way that they designed the midsole... And, of course, I'm a big fan of when they enclose the boost.
Absolutely agree with that. I think the shape of the shoe... says comfort to me, but I do like a little, like, comfort to me also means make sure that my foot's in there, and like the sock doesn't give me the structure over the foot that I want. We got a little Kobe face off here.
Out of these,
we got the easy. 5 Chaos and the 7 Galaxy.
I was not a fan of the 7.
Really?
5 Chaos, easy.
Okay.
Plus, I remember a bunch of people I knew getting these when they first came out and loving the shit out of them.
I like them both, but I would surprisingly go with the 7s here. Also, in the hopes that I could go a size down to like maybe a 10 or 10 and a half, because the smaller this shoe is, the better it looks. Because you start, like, even a size 12 in those 7s looks a little bit long in the toes, bro. Look like you got toes that could, like, hold and peel a banana.
Oh, I hate that about larger shoes.
Some winterized navy blue Heat.
This is a good combo because you know how much I like that Yeezy. But I do like the Swinterize 4. Shit. This is a good one. but I'm going to go with the Yeezy on this again.
100%. 100%.
I saw it out in public, and even if it wasn't Yeezy, I think it's just a dope shoe. Like, that really resonates with me.
Agreed. The lines in that are fantastic. That's the win right there. 500 high. All right. Off-White Dunk versus the Ray Guns.
Ray Guns. Easy. I want the black ones, though.
Well, that's not what it is.
I know.
It's the white Ray Guns.
Yeah, whatever. I'll take the white ones. Take the white ones over that off-white one. Because I know that Ray Gun's going to wear the one the way that I want it to. The other one's like a shell of a dunk.
That is something that we have been seeing. There's some weirdness to the structure and shape of that dunk. The off-white.
It's like an imposter. It's like when they take the mask off of Scooby-Doo. At the end, it's all like a flabby mask. That's what it looks like it's made out of. It looks like a fake, like, here, this will pack well. You know, like those shoes that just like break down and like you can sandwich together.
It's like a fruit roll up wrapped over some like other Payless shoe.
Give me the structure.
Yeah. I mean, I'm drawn by that color. That's it. Like,
oh yeah, no, you can't. I won't deny that the color decision that they made were fantastic.
I do really,
and I
like,
was a fan of it. Like, if it was not built that way, I think I would be interested in getting that like Michigan color pair.
Yeah,
really like that, the navy blue with that like gold yellow.
Yeah, so you're saying if it had like an SB shape, like these Ray Guns here,
the structure, and the shape, I think it's way off. Look how big.
Well, should be noted the off-white is not an SB, so there is going to be some difference in shape, but it still
looks like way too thick of a...
Like, too tall in the toe box?
Too tall in the toe.
I mean, a little bit. Like, in general, the classic dunk, I think, is taller in the toe box than the SB. You need a little.
It's got a different tongue. Like, there's a lot going on with that. The white one.
Agreed.
So Ray Gun for me.
Yeah, I got it. Especially the white Ray Guns. If it was the black Ray Guns, I would be kind of like, eh, I'm an indifferent. Dial it and flip a coin.
I didn't know being indifferent was a choice.
Is it? Okay. I mean, you're right. Whatever. Somebody's got to die. So Ray Gun. Pew pew.
Pew pew.
Last one. Oh, we got a light that died. That's all good. We on the slide anyway. So you got 8 racks. You can only spend it on a pair of Red Octobers or this used Chevy from CarMax.
The car? I don't know. No, the shoes. The shoes might actually appreciate.
Agreed.
That's the actual answer.
That is surprisingly the answer, despite what non-sneakerheads might tell you. Now, you also have to understand that getting your priorities right is an issue here, too. If you don't have a fucking means of transportation, then that car might get you to a job to go make some real motherfucking money. But I got a car, so I don't need another one. And like you said, the car's gonna depreciate. The sneakers might
most likely not
will likely appreciate in value. That's it, man.
All right, man. Good episode.
Thank you for tuning in, everybody. We'll see you next week.
On another one.
We out. Air it out. Peace.
We literally have to open the doors and air it out right now.
Yeah.
Shit.